You're a very important and precious person in my life. Ever since I know, the very few people who've been consistent in my life, you've been one of them. You've got a very logical brain. Someone who understands things very easily, is very passionate, very loving. At times can be very misunderstood. You're very straightforward. And so am I. So I understand you very well. I understand that you need to be straightforward because you need to be clear. And I love that bit about you. Thank you. The other thing is you've got mastery over your topic. I remember coming to you and I was late by almost 2 hours, guys. And she said, I don't have time. And I said, main to aa rahi hu. You can come, give me a hug and go. And my creative visualization is always so goddamn strong that I reached there. And she said, aajo andar, abhi mera client aaya nahi hai. So, jab tak inhone mera kaam nahi kiya na, inka client aaya nahi. So, I'm very lucky that she took me in on that day. She made me aware of a few things. She's got these measuring instruments. First thing she made me aware of that my body was actually working at 78 years of age. I remember everything. And then she said, she gave me a diet, which was just something that was very difficult for me to follow because she said no non-vegetarian. And mera kya hai, I'm born non-vegetarian. So I'll explain to you why I say I'm a born non-vegetarian. I come from a family where non-veg was not allowed. Forget non-veg, lassan, garlic was not allowed. I come from such a family. They ate pure ghee and they believed in everything natural. But my doctor said when I was 6 years of age and I was left with my grandmother, Galaxy on max, please mute yourself. Galaxy on max, please mute yourself. Whoever is Galaxy on max, please mute yourself. So she said to me, Anu, you can't have non-veg. And here in my nani's house, where I stayed in my childhood without my mom, I felt very unwell. And doctor said she will not survive if you don't give her non-veg. So because of me, eggs started in their house. And because of me, they had to get chicken and I would sit outside in the car and have it. In fact, my story goes even before that. When my parents were bringing me up and my mom, obviously, like I told you, no eggs, no garlic, nothing. And I was staying in a house which was, you know, very close to what we call. So I had sardars in the same house. The landlords were sardars. And they would carry me to their house and feed me non-veg. So when Jyoti, you said no non-veg, I actually went out and had 2 frankies on that day. Because kal se non-veg nahi milega. I continued not having non-veg for almost 4 months. But in that 4 months, wherever I traveled, those places were all non-vegetarian. So I couldn't keep up with no non-veg, but I kept one thing on, which I just probably have given up now because of the lockdown. And that was the fruit mix that you had asked me to have with pudina, fruits, banana. I would love it. She also started me on alsi. Seeds, and she started me on methi powdered seeds, which I have till today. And she also said something that's very significant. Please have more water. Please have as much water as you can. I did all that and I did benefit hugely. I never came back because I didn't have the time. It was nothing to do with you were splendid. It was just me. So I am in deep gratitude to you, and I'm calling you on this forum because I know during the lockdown, our diets have gone for a mess. I'm not someone who likes to diet, but I like to eat healthy. And the process of cooking for everyone, I seem to be making stuff which is healthy, which my kids should be actually having, but not me. So welcome and thank you so much into my small world with a beautiful spiritual family that I have, and with deep gratitude to each and every one of you, because if you're not there, I can't run the show. And every time I think I must take this off air, because you know, this is like 36th talk that we are doing today. The bun goes even further. So the talks are going to continue till the 16th of May, guys. Jyoti, over to you. Thank you.
Thank you so much for such a lovely introduction. And definitely you're very, very special. I'll just start off straight with the presentation. I'll speak about myself for sure.
But give us your qualification, because some people don't know you at all. And I didn't give your qualifications. Thank you.
I will definitely do that, because if people don't know me, then, you know, that's all the thing becomes.
No, it's really important that people know you. We have 72 people already.
Wow. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Can you see the screen? I'm trying to share the screen, actually.
Yes, I can see the screen.
Somehow I'm not able to see it still.
It's very loud and clear over here.
Okay.
So when you move, I will help you on the other side. So don't worry.
I'm just wondering whether this...
It's going perfect. You're on the slide number one now.
Okay. So you're getting to see that, right?
Yes, absolutely.
So
that's 74 count.
Wow. That's great. So welcome everyone, and so lovely to see you all at this time. I know a lot of people here, in terms of we're looking at a lot of my friends, patients, and my Metta family. So just a little introduction about me. Holistic for sure, that's what I would call myself. I've done my graduation and post-graduation in dietetics, after which I was working in a hospital. So definitely you need this basic degrees to work in a hospital. So I was a chief dietitian with Hinduja Hospital as my last job. In 2008, I left, and 16 years job experience. Now, what did the allopathy dietetics basically focus on is more of the calories and more of the hormones and the basic science. I also was definitely curious to know how it really works in terms of nature, since we are part of nature. So I also did my MD in naturopathy. And since we said genetics is the big, big reason for a lot of things, I also did my nutrigenomics. But you know, as we say, seekers are finders. So I reached to Anu with my whole pitara of questions of getting to why does a cancer take place? Why does a rheumatoid arthritis come in? And trust me, guys, I got all my answers in Metta Health for the cause of the situations. All the diseases, all the answers definitely opened up to me. And then definitely as the spiritual journey started, I also did a lot of pranic healing courses. And definitely if I want to be a life coach, it has to be more of the NLP skills, a lot of healing courses. So this is a little about me. What I say is more of working on the mental body, the emotional body, the spiritual body, and of course the physical body. That's what the diet does. So everything according to me is important. What we think, what we feel, what we are eating is also part of what's going in our body. So it's equally important for sure. Now, when we say a word diet, it's nothing like I go on diet or off diet. You know, this is a very common thing that I hearing people saying, I'm off diet. From the time we are born, I say we are on a very bad mouthed right now in terms of, oh, you're on a diet. So We start with a breast milk diet, a weaning diet, a pediatric diet, an adolescent diet, menopause diet. A sports person will go on a sports nutrition diet, and the old age will go on a geriatric diet. So diet is not something that we should run away from. It is part of us right from the time we are born. I'll just go to a little bit of history of what actually have we covered today in this talk. My intention here is not to stop anything from anyone, let's say non-veg, veg, but just to highlight and give you information. Like how Anu rightly said, I'm a very logical person. So get the facts straightforward. This is what it is. I've evaluated. This is from where it started. And then you have a choice from where you move. You move ahead and you want to go in from a non-veg diet to a veg, or you want to stick to non-veg, and maybe instead of eating 8 meals a week of non-veg, you can go to 5 meals. You can decide. It's always a freedom. There's nothing like you stop this totally and you stop that totally. Is that clear so far, Anu?
Absolutely. Anu? Absolutely clear.
Okay. Absolutely. And is everyone getting it in terms of the pace I'm speaking?
Everybody can put in the chat fatafat whether you're getting it, the pace. Just if you feel that her pace is okay, just type yes, 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 yes. So everybody can, she can see it. You can see the chat
as of now. I will try to open the chat right now. I'm just getting used to the.
So everybody's saying yes, 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 yes,
yes.
Everybody's saying yes.
Because the way I'm talking is how I talk in a clinic. I'm not doing anything beyond that right now. That's why I said, let me just check the pace is okay or not.
Brilliant.
This is me talking. That's the way it is.
There are 80 people right now.
Wow.
Yeah. As high as Nayati's.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So
27 people saying yes, yes, yes. Jyoti, you can be louder, please. Some of them are saying you can be louder.
Okay.
Maybe a little bit slower would be nicer.
Okay, done.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. So now we go right from our ancestral time. Originally, as even before we call ourselves humans, we were really hunter-gatherers, I would say. Way before agriculture started, we were actually hunting, gathering, fishing, and eating that sort of meat only. The main food was maybe fruits from trees and the fishing and whatever was available as the animals were cooked in the jungle. So that's where we originally started off, ancestrally. And now if you look, there are very few of these hunter-gatherers as tribes on our planet. Most of us have moved to agricultural lands. So when we're looking at agriculture, actually came in some 10,000 years ago. So agriculture, the normal food that we are eating, honestly, there was no problem till it started getting westernized. Now the medical issues started only after there was a steep rise in the refining of these carbohydrates, the foods that we eat. So once the Western countries started doing that, then it came down to Asia. And by, let's say, 100 years ago, we started having or seeing diseases which were never seen earlier, what we now commonly call as lifestyle diseases. Now, even if I look at 1958, the first book that was published was Eat Fat and Grow Slim, where this person, Richard, was actually insisting on go on a low carb because there was a lot of refined flour being used. Then we had Dr. Atkin. I'm sure there are a lot of people in the 70s who would have heard of Dr. Atkin because it was a craze then, where he just gave a free hand. You go ahead and eat as much fat and protein as you want and people would lose weight. At the same time, the pharma industry also came over and there was a lot of contradictions on this, as well as a lot of, how dangerous this is, how misleading it is, all these things started. So the fat was created as the big villain, honestly. So when that became the villain, you do not have too much of fat, it's really not good. This was also stopped. But originally, if you look at the Atkins diet, and now what we look as commonly as a ketogenic diet, which is commonly used in a lot of gyms out here or even abroad, this is quite similar. Only thing is Atkins was not really calculated. Now we come to what is ketogenic diet, because that is something very popular, especially with non-vegetarians, I would say. And it's very attractive, isn't it? Because you're allowed to eat what? You're allowed to eat a lot of fat. You're allowed to eat a lot of cream, cheese, non-veg, which normally most of the diets would say restrict, reduce. The issue is that people start following these ketogenic diets more so from a lot of, not qualified people, or just take some information online. That is really harming the system, if not medically done. So they go from whatever protein you need, they give a high protein, which can, you know, tax the kidney up. They go from as much fat as you wish to just a moderate amount. So I will definitely cover what actually is required, but basically I'm just talking of actual ketogenic diet versus what is available as what we call keto diet, but we are not even sure of what we are eating. So now coming to basically, if I'm looking at a ketogenic diet, since when am I as Jyoti Lalwani aware of ketogenic diet? Way back in India, it came in 1996. I still remember, that was just before my daughter was born. And we learned it for our epilepsy patients, the ones who get fits. So originally, we never learned it for weight loss. This was for the fits. Now, how does the mechanism work? We as a body always work on glucose. Everyone knows energy chahiye, sugar chahiye, converts to glucose. We learn this from school. Now, if we are fasting, then this glucose gets over. Like even a Jain will keep a fast, even a normal fast. So we know that there is a certain amount of glucose and then we go low in sugar, correct? So at that time, the body starts breaking the fat reserve. Now, originally, this fat reserve to break down is what was helping in controlling the neurosystem. Neurologically, the epilepsy is there, which is always known. And now we have a lot of medical issues being resolved with ketogenic diet, like Parkinson's or Alzheimer's. So it has its benefits. We also know that the brain needs much more fat to function, but the right type of fat and right amount of fat. That is very important. So fat itself is not really the villain, but it is how we consume and with what we consume. Now, everyone will wonder if normally, you know, we hear from everyone, the medical ground or everyone, eat less oil, eat less fat, then how is this ketogenic diet really working? Because main thing is when you enter this ketosis, ketosis is when your body stops using glucose and starts using fat. At that time, you will get your low appetite. You don't feel like eating much. You're just feeling full all the time. So automatically, you are eating a limited portion. At that point of time, you can easily manage to sustain through the next meal by just surviving on these proteins and fats. Few popular film stars of ours who have been on keto diet because their work demands it, and definitely we've seen their inch loss, we've seen how they look on screen. So I'm sure you all know at least half a dozen more names, and if you search online you'll get way more. So a lot of our Bollywood,
your voice is breaking, is what few people are saying. Can you raise your hand or put it on the chat? Is everybody feeling like this, or only Dr. Manorama? Is everybody else okay with the sound, or is it only Dr. Manorama?
Fine.
Okay, fine. Continue.
Continue.
Continue, please.
Yeah.
So there is Lavina who's saying it. There is, yes, in between it is breaking. Dr. Okay. Archana Kumar saying slight cracking. There are a few people who are saying that it's breaking.
Do you want me to repeat anything? I can go back and repeat.
Just go back in the last 5 minutes and repeat it, please. Thank you.
Sure. So how does ketogenic diet work to lose weight? The main reason why ketogenic diet works is because once we reach ketosis, ketosis is happening when we stop burning glucose, as there are no reserves left, and we switch our body to burning out fat. That is the time the body comes with high ketone bodies, which is medically called ketosis. At this stage, the appetite comes down. So that is the reason why a person can sustain through this diet for some time. most inspiring people who have been on the diet are the Bollywood celebrities, I would say. Even Hollywood, there are a few definitely, but Bollywood is also there. Give me a moment. Okay, this is the next one here. So I just said you can go online and see there are half a dozen more of Bollywood stars who've been on this, and we've seen their dramatic inch loss on screen. Now coming to another picture, what actually am I seeing in the clinic? Honestly, I am attending more cases of side effects of ketogenic diet than actual ketogenic diet in my clinic. Now, let's go through just the pros and cons, because if you're doing this, you need to know what exactly are you doing and what exactly are you heading for. Okay. So, pros would be definitely, as I already spoke, better satiety, good and quick inch loss, so you feel good when you're looking good. And you can eat all the cheese, cream, paneer, non-veg, which earlier diets all have been said no. But as I said, the main pro for me as a clinical dietitian is I'm using it more therapeutically for brain tumors, for Parkinson's, for epilepsy, for Alzheimer's, and even a just started diabetes who has her visceral fat normal. So visceral fat is your internal fat, which decides whether you're going to get lifestyle diseases, which starts as a fatty liver. Just for information, yeah. The cons. What are the basic cons of a ketogenic diet? It would be constipation first, because you're not having much of the fiber, you're not having a lot of water. It's a slight dehydration that happens in this case, and that's the reason. There also could be leading for kidney stones. There could also be high uric acid, because ultimately the water is dependent on the cleansing of the body. So if low water already, can't give too much of non-veg, can't give too much of fat, because body will not be able to clean up. Low sodium, low magnesium, people feel a little nauseated, dehydrated at the initial stage on a ketogenic diet. We also call it a keto flu. You know, for people who have been very high sugar and then they suddenly withdraw. It's like a symptom of withdrawal where they feel a flu type symptom or a fatigue. Definitely, there are vitamin deficiencies, the supplements, hair loss, skin getting spoiled, and definitely all supplements and treatments from the cosmetologist would be in tow. Medical reports is what we always insist. Let's say even if I put a healthy person on ketogenic diet, I would still keep getting their medical reports done every 6 weeks just to know that they haven't started a medical issue. Another thing I would say, sustainability. That's a major issue. Like in the lockdown now, the people who've been on a keto diet says, I can't do this with my family because they are eating everything and suddenly I just can't be sitting with my food. But while they're working and they get a different delivered with the keto food, they find that very convenient. So it's a choice, finally. That's what I have to say about the ketogenic diet. Now, when we look at the universe, there always is a balance created. So on one side, when the whole world, the West and India and everywhere, the keto became famous, we also had a movie released, or a documentary, I would say, called Game Changers. Are you aware of that? Has anyone seen that? It's on Netflix. It's even there on YouTube.
Now, yeah, I have.
Great. So if you haven't, you must go and see it. It's very inspiring. There are a lot of sports people have got together and made it. But that's another extreme. So we're talking now 180 degrees different. But this is very close to what our Indians have been, our ancient Indian diet, what we call our Sattvic diet. Now, the Sattvic diet is lacto-vegetarian, means it's pure vegetarian with the milk and milk products. That's your original Sattvic diet, which believes in non-violence, definitely. When we switch to vegan diet, it excludes the milk and milk products, because as of now, what we are living, the space that we're living in, there's a lot of cruelty in which they are milking the cows. There's a lot of hormones being added. And even if you look at just the taste, and when we are having milk, you will know that what was there 10 years or 20 years ago, that taste doesn't exist anymore. So we know that we are not really having the pure things. So that's the reason why the vegan diet then came in play. Otherwise, originally in India, it was just the vegetarian diet, which majority of people would follow. Now, we, you know, know, the sad part is we learn things from the West. We don't really listen to India as much, which is really, really sad. So when we had this American person, John McDougall, writing a book on the low-fat, whole plant-based diet, the veganism really started off. In the medical sciences, we had Dean Ornish. A lot of publications, a lot of work. He came in with a lot of this for the cardiac issues. So he has proved that cardiac problems, even a bypass surgery, can be reversed. You know, like if you're going in for a bypass, he says you don't need to do it, and you go on this high-fiber plant-based diet, and it actually reverses. So Dean Ornish is a very popular name even in the allopathy medical science now, because he has proven it by clinical trials. He's also added exercise, yoga, meditation, stress management. So it's a very holistic base. And let me just share, okay, he does add milk, by the way, but only controls it to 10%, you know, of the fats. The best part is in his book, when I was reading, he has given credit to our Swamiji here in India. So Satchidanand Saraswati is his Indian religious teacher. So imagine that we listen only if it's coming from abroad. It's really, really ironic. You know, it's something like Haldi Wala Dood we know, but now it's curcumin latte abroad. And I'm sure you'll understand what I mean, that we wait for the West to give a green signal. Now we come to why vegan. So why is everybody promoting a veganism? Or why would I suggest a vegan diet for somebody, even maybe for some time? So it's a very good cleansing diet. If there is any acute disease which has come in for the body, because it eliminates so many food groups, it's easier for the body to digest. If you realize that as a natural instinct, we naturally, by nature, are attracted to more fruits. Let's say if you're in an orchard and you're seeing a fruit hanging on a tree, by nature, you would want to pluck it. But if you see a hen walking on the road, you do not have a natural instinct to go and catch it and eat it. Obviously, cut it, cook it and eat it, but that's no natural instinct. So we are actually going to save animals by being less torturous to them, or, you know, let them also survive with us on this planet peacefully. You know, we don't want to coexist. We want to dominate. That's one thing that veganism is, you know, loud about. There's a lot of torture being done. And there are a lot of studies which are saying of the future of the planet can only improve if at least 70 to 80% of people turn towards veganism. We can just go step by step, I guess. And health parameters, I would say, definitely beneficial. We've seen that in a lot of blood reports, a lot of people out, my patients, even here, I'm sure. For some time, my first diets would very often be vegan. So what you were put on, Annu, was a cleansing diet, which would be vegan for some time, and then you would switch to. So the smoothie in the morning cleansing time does help in the body, rejuvenating and restarting. It's not a permanent diet.
So guys, that was outstanding.
Jyoti, that was your struggle.
Jyoti, that was outstanding. It was outstanding. It was amazing. Yeah, thank you.
So, you know, it's just that people should share back, is what I was just trying to say by saying that. Is that if you're struggling with something, no problem. You know, we always aim for 80% milna chahiye, 90%. But hello, if you're struggling, even a 50 is good, even a 40 is good. At least go from not failing in your health. That's the intention. So that is the simple veganism. Now we go to what is the vegan diet? So basically, yes, we talk about a lot of fruits, limited amount of whole grains, and definitely fats should be not there or limited there, depending on the medical condition. For a normal person, I would say go ahead and use a little bit of oil. But knowing that it is too refined, if it has got too much chemicals, it doesn't really make any sense. So be cautious. What happens is just be one step ahead of what you are doing right now. That's the way I would look at it. So if you're at refined sugars, you're eating white sugar, you can switch to a jaggery. If you're eating jaggery, you can switch to dates and raisins and prunes and anjeer, the natural sugars. Because the more refined, even if it is vegan, but it has got more chemicals, right? So that's not natural. So as far as possible, the natural, what nature has made for us, is what I would look at. Now, when we're looking at vegan diet, don't think in my clinic I don't get side effects of vegan. Though they are few, One is people feel, okay, vegan allowed, hai, let me have vegan cake, almond cream, this, that. I don't know, a lot of stuff has come across in the market. So they have the coconut butter, they have a lot of, you know, those cashews, and making a lot of curd and n number of things. There's cheese made with cashews, so there are a lot of recipes available. So people forget that they also need to count calories. If you're not burning out so much, then you can't afford to eat, even if it is from a plant source. So that is something that I would like to emphasize here, because everyone feels, vegan khaya, so then I should have got weight loss. Why didn't that happen? So then it didn't work for me. So that's the way. I would look at first, just eliminate outside food. Eliminate processed food. You know, the very basic thing that we can start off with. At least stop foods from a packet. You know, the biscuits, the bread, even if they are pure veg. I mean, surprisingly, you will see even a brown bread today has milk solids. So even that's not vegan, by the way. So just sharing that, even a Pringles or a Lay's wafers does have some milk solids. So a lot of these food items are being added with milk solids just to enhance the taste. Because milk can be very addictive. The chemicals can be addictive. So I would just add that. I would tell people, even if you think you're on a vegan, don't think it's healthy. If you're having from a packaged food and saying that, hello, it's pure veg. Vegan community, the latest ones who joined in is Virat and Anushka. They saw this movie, The Game Changers. Just sharing it. I heard it on Virat's tweet and then I went and actually saw the movie. Amit Way became way before that. And I'm sure for a lot of us, it would be very difficult, right? From childhood, if I put someone on a vegetarian diet, and, you know, if it, there is a Parsi, there is a, let's say, a Christian, Muslim, who've been eating 3 times a day non-veg, for them to suddenly go, even reducing it down is very tough. But there have been times in my clinic, I've actually given them basic recipes, if they are medically needed to. So if you're talking of simple weight loss, I don't need to go so strict. But I attend more, let's say, clinical cases, like 70% of mine are with diseases. So then definitely I would look at being a little more strict. Now, the vegan diet pros and cons. Okay, so we're getting vitamins and minerals because we're having more natural food. So supplementation, yes, I do need a vitamin B12 supplementation because the B12 is only present in the non-veg food. That's the fact. And even in milk items. The non-veg and the milk is also first-class proteins. In the veg, I would only have soya or tofu, which many people are allergic to or do not like. So that is missing in the vegan diet. That's definitely high in fiber. And for us, very close to our traditional meals, if I look at a simple Indian thali. Environmentally, ecologically, very easily available. If I were to say now at home, you sit and make a ketogenic diet or a simple vegan diet. It would be easier for you to make more of the ketogenic. I'm sorry, the vegan diet. Okay, so far, then we go to the intermittent fasting. That's the next hot topic around. What do you say, guys? Is it going okay? Or you want to take a pause?
No, it's perfectly fine. It's perfectly okay. Going very well. Go ahead.
It's going great, Jyoti.
Yeah. Great.
Okay, I was just checking the time as well, because so now we come to intermittent fasting. Well, this terminology was just coined a few years back, and I studied 27-28 years back. Well, this didn't exist in our textbooks, but when I studied this, I found it very close to our naturopathy, our Ayurveda, our Jainism. Everybody talks of this. So again, this term has come from the West, intermittent fasting. But what does it really mean? It really indicates that you need to have your dinner early and keep a long gap before which you have your next cooked meal. What happens in this gap? Basically, digesting food also requires a lot of energy. So only if you rest the body will it be able to digest better. There was in 2016 or 17, there was this Nobel Prize winner who also said fasting is activating autophagy, after which this became very popular. Basically, what is autophagy? It's basically healing of the body, just to give it to you in a simple. I only suggest a person who can fit it in his lifestyle should do it. I have not seen an issue with people who are, let's say, weight loss, having 4 meals a day, but let's say having fruits, having your normal food, and having 2 meals a day and still not losing weight. So they both are managing. It's not that we don't get results with a 4 meal pattern or with the 2 meal pattern. We are getting results with both happening. So if it fits in your lifestyle, this is very good. Whom does it fit really? It fits very good with corporate people who, you know, have a very heavy lunch maybe in the corporate available. And I would suggest don't eat that. You know, eat one meal and go, and eat one meal and come back, and probably just have some fruits in between. So those are the people I would give it to. How would I say Jainism? Because pre-sunset they eat. Naturopathy says have between 6 and 8. So if you're having an early dinner, what does this really cut down? It really cut down our midnight snacks. Why does the result? Why did intermittent fasting become so popular? Because our midnight snacks were all cut off. Everyone sitting on Netflix and Amazon is sitting with something or the other with them, or even on television. You know, they want to eat some chips, they want to eat something or the other going in. I wouldn't just name all the junk food, even some would eat healthy. But well, everything then gets cut off if you're doing an intermittent fasting. So that is a major advantage. And if you are, let's following a 2-meal pattern, then your RDAs, your requirement of your dietary allowances really needs to be calculated. Because to fit everything in those 2 meals is tough. To break it down to 4 meals is very easy. I would definitely not recommend intermittent fasting to people who are taking too many allopathy medicines. Because let's say if you're taking a diabetes medicine supposed to be given by the doctor post-breakfast, and you don't eat breakfast, but you eat your medicine, you could go into low sugar. And trust me, there have been people who've done this. So just saying by experience, I suggest, as a general rule, if you're on too many medications, because the doctors always will suggest it, assuming you're eating a breakfast, lunch, dinner on a proper time and a little tea time. So, you know, that's a typical pattern we follow in a hospital. So
there's a question for you. There's a question for you. The question is, does the intermittent fasting period change according to the gender?
No, should it? So what I recommend is at least 12 hours is mandatory for everybody. Even we know when we go for a blood test, you do a 12 hours fasting. When you give a blood sugar, a lipid profile, that's a mandatory fasting for everyone, right? Even from a newborn child, don't we feed the child at night and then encourage the child to have only in the morning? We stop the midnight feeds first, correct? So when we are looking at 12 hours, then we increase it to 14, 13, then you go to 16. So if you can't go to 16, and let's say you're consistent at 14, you'll be there. What are you stopping? So if as gender, if I feel there is a lady who's at home and is exposed to food too much, so she gets too tempted, probably, I'm just hypothetically assuming this lady is a little housewife or sitting at home, or right now how we are in a lockdown, then to keep that fasting when you're all the time tempted for food may be a little difficult. So that itself doesn't answer your question, whoever is asking. So it's not really gender biased, it's more lifestyle biased.
Does that answer your question? Please unmute yourself and let her know.
Yes.
Great. Wonderful. There is Poonam who is asking a question. Poonam, yes. Please unmute yourself and ask. Okay, she raised her hand, but that's okay. You can go on.
Do we take all the questions now, or should I complete and then we take the questions, whatever?
Yeah, we generally don't. We will take, guys, you can put your questions. We'll take the questions right at the end. That would make it easier for everyone. Thank you.
Because I have an idea of how much to cover and how much time do we have.
Don't worry about the time. You take your time. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, you know, what we're really covering right now is the trends and, you know, clearing some myths out. What I was really interested as discussed with you on phone, Anu. So my intention was to just give a general knowledge or a general basic on, these are the terms we keep using and seeing it on social media all the time.
You're doing a brilliant job. It's just that people are getting so enthusiastic that they want to ask a question. And it looked so relevant that I wanted to not kind
of.
I
can take a hold and actually do it. Yeah, I can do these questions and then probably.
You could do that also because they're coming on the chat, so you could look at it and so and because yeah. Yes. Thank you so much.
So, I could also is that, yes. Does the intermittent, okay, so gender we completed. Any vegetables that are high on B12? Anju, it's very negligible amount. There are some of them, but honestly, I'll tell you, even the non-veg people hardly get B12. We're all low on B12 and need supplementation. So I wouldn't even consider that to worry about the B12 bit from the food. But as a textbook, yes, I know that B12 doesn't exist much in veg food or vegan food. What else is there? How frequently should intermittent fasting be done in a week? No. It's a lifestyle. You can't be doing it few days and few days more. You have to adapt to what is comfortable and do it as a lifestyle as far as possible. I suggest a lifestyle is what you need to pick on. In fact, this diet and life, that logo also I really thought a lot and then put, because this diet is not temporary. It's a lifestyle. That's the intention of the message that I've given. And I've used that as a topic because people need to understand there is no temporary work happening here. The sun rises, it rises in the morning. It could be 15, 20 minutes here and there. That doesn't matter. But by and large, it can't be rising in the evening and then you're confused. So that doesn't work. You know, some days it doesn't rise at all. We wonder what's happening. So some days doing this and some days no is what I would suggest, not workable. In the long run, don't confuse your body too much. Stick to what you're doing, be happy with it. It doesn't matter. There are, in fact, studies of people comparing to if they're having a constant weight, whether it's high or it is normal or it is low, but it's constant, versus people who are going on yo-yo diets. Yo-yo is the ones, you know, how people go to, let's say, a farms and naturopathy and come down 20 kilos and then again come back and gain maybe 20 to 25 kilos. So these sort of things which they do every 6 months to a year, that is more harmful than being constantly at a weight for a long time, and going gradually is the best. So it is never drastic which is advised. If you suddenly gain back, it's a big problem. So even if you are, let's say, doing an extreme diet, you need to go slowly into the ketogenic and slowly come out of it. You have to wean out of it. You can't be stopping it suddenly. It doesn't work that way for a lifestyle. Then you're definitely going to put on much more than what you were earlier. So, and with these small things that we need to keep in mind is that these are all lifestyle things we're talking about, not general. You know, you do it as you wish. Today, I feel like doing this. So that's the way it works. Yeah. That doesn't matter. Any other questions?
Deva. दादू को बोल दादी इधर बैठी
पूनम वासवानी और फोन इज नॉट म्यूट ओके आई थिंक वी आर डन विद द क्वेश्चन
हाय कैन आई आस्क यू
यस प्लीज आस्क
Can I ask you?
Yes, please ask.
Yes, I wanted to ask, children can do intermittent diet. Is it advisable?
There is no problem. Even Jain children do eat early dinner and then have a morning meals weight. There is no problem.
Any growth problem if they do
not
this?
In fact, I would suggest, because I know you're a doctor, Nobel Prize winner's fasting activates autophagy. It's a very lovely article and it'll open up a lot of how healing and the body growth takes place better.
Guys,
I doctor need to ask you. I'm Nalini Puri. Yes, can I ask you a question, doctor?
Yes, Nalini, tell me.
Yeah. Doctor, I'm on a thyroid medication.
Correct.
So they say you have to take early in the morning. But if you are doing intermittent fasting, so then my thyroid medicines, you know, then when should I take it? Like after 12 hours, 14 hours, like how?
Thyroid medicine is not connected with diet. It should be connected as a 24-hour cycle and empty stomach. There are only two rules of the hypothyroid medicine.
Okay.
It has to be empty stomach and once in 24 hours. So if you're taking it at 7 in the morning, continue taking it at 7 in the morning.
So that then
it won't impact your food. Even hypertension tablet won't impact food. But diabetes will impact the food. So diabetes medicine and intermittent fasting, you have to take medical guidance. Do not take it otherwise.
Jyoti, is green tea allowed in intermittent fasting, like in between there's a bracket of 16 hours?
again, if I look at green tea, if you have with the caffeine, then ideally that should not be allowed. So green tea, if you're having your no natural lemongrass and tulsi leaves and curry leaves and whatever you put as a concoction at home, or you get decaffeinated, the basic organic green tea, it's allowed. So basically, I do not want chemicals going, because the minute a chemical is going in the body, it is toxic. So the liver will start working at throwing that out. Then when will the liver repair? That is the intention. So does that answer your question? Green tea is something you can have, but be very specific on the type of green tea. There is a question by Veer Shah. What is the article you spoke about? Growth in children and fasting. So this is not article on growth in children only. It is an article on fasting activates autophagy. That's on my slide right now. Fasting activates autophagy by Nobel Prize winner Yoshinori. You can get this online also. He's won the prize for just proving that this is absolutely same or similar as what we call a Jainism fast. Since we are used to having Jains around us and knowing how they function, that's the reason. And very simply put, it is the body will only heal if you are stopping to give it food to digest, logically. So don't give it too much of food. Give it a break. It will heal on its own. Okay. Anju Kapoor, can we eat fish in vegan diet? So vegan diet is only plant-based diet. So fish will not be included. You could always have a fish along with vegetarian diet and not call it vegan. There is no problem. Fish is healthy. And as of now, it's not as contaminated because we mostly eat fresh fish in Mumbai. And we don't have too much of chemicals. But the people who are eating the frozen packets, even frozen prawns and XYZ, those are the ones I wouldn't recommend. So again, I'm more anti-chemicals than anti-anything else. Comparatively, I would say amongst the non-veg food, the fish is the safest. Organic eggs are easily available now. That would be another option. Dr. Sumit has written, okay. Thanks, Sumit. Yeah, got me down 20 kilos. I didn't do it. I just guide. You followed the diet and you did what you did, Sumit. So hats off to you for that. He's just complimented on I got him down 20 kilos, which I feel I just died. Okay. So.
Sorry, I just wanted to make a point. It was without fasting and you just taught me the lifestyle, which is going along with the logo that you have, Diet and Life. Thank you.
Absolutely. So my whole intention is I do not generally want to change too much. My diets are more personalized. So where you are, if you are at this stage, just go one step ahead. You don't need to go drastic. You know, people tend to go drastically for a few days to keto, vegan or intermittent and then in the end do nothing. So, just take one step ahead. Okay, am I eating packaged food? Let me stop that. Am I eating white sugar? Let me stop that. So, just take one step at a time. You will still achieve your results. And the best way to know your results is what you feel when you wake up in the morning. Because that's when you already slept and got up. Your body's had time to heal. So you will know the energy difference. I'm sure Sumit can even share that. There's immediately a difference in his body when he goes on a healthy diet. And he's a foodie. So there's nothing wrong about it. But the days he has eaten some junk versus the days he's fresh, he tells me there's a clear difference, which he now knows. Yes, Sumit, would you like to add something?
Yes, in fact, the major difference that I get to see is what I feel in myself, specifically with the best part is, you know, the kind of homemade powders that you give me and your mantra that subah jaise jhadu lagate hain, waise powder khana hai aur jhadu lagana hai. You know, I can never forget that. And but it actually works like a jhadu, I'll tell you. All my acidity problem has gone off. I started developing that almost 10 years back. And since 10 years I was having, now that I am almost reaching 40, that was a perpetual problem. So that has gone off. That is one. Second, the moment you ask me to go on my watch my diet with including at least 4 fruits a day, since I'm a huge sweet tooth, you will not believe the moment I'm on 4 fruits a day, as per what you had said, I stop eating chocolates. You know, because I don't crave for chocolates at all. Because I think the natural sweetener that I get from the fruits. Now, another major thing that you've drilled in my mind is that agar
I can't hear you. Yeah. Hello.
So dal lo, but then you know that will only spoil my vehicle.
Sumit, there is a problem with your voice.
What I suggest is let me complete and then we do this, because I think a few people have written that on the chat. So let's do that. Yes, Anu? Hello? Am I audible?
I think it will be best if you continue with your presentation and then we go for question answers. We have enough time, guys. Just wait, okay. Because she has so much to give. Thank you.
So what I was saying is, right now, instead of just touching upon all these diets, which are so, different in their ways, let's first speak on the very basic diet, you know, which we studied from school and which even a doctor speaks about when you go. So when we're looking at good nutrition, it could be our Indian thali and it could be this burger and fries. By the way, they have same calories, the two images that I'm showing you. But if I were to look at nutrition point of view, they are not the same. Because we're looking at nutrition, we look at all the macronutrients and the micronutrients. Now, when I'm talking of macronutrients, what am I really talking about? So when we're speaking of a diet, which any of this, like how Sumit was mentioning, I didn't give him any extreme diets, very basic. So when you're looking at starches, your carbohydrates, your proteins, it'll all come as a basic. Vegetables and fruits you increase, and you reduce your meat and milk and reduce your fats. It's very basic. What is macronutrient? For the people who are not from the medical or nutritional background or not aware, let me just specify. A macro is the big nutrient which gives calories. So protein gives 4 calories per gram, carbohydrates give 4 calories per gram, and fats will give 9 calories per gram. So when I say protein, milk we know is a high protein. We also have dals and pulses which are protein, like a ghoda, a horse, will eat chana and still have the muscle. So don't think only I need to have milk or meat to get the muscle. I'm just giving you an example. Yeah, the carbohydrates, when we're looking at our main functional food, we're looking at our Indian diet is so carbs dominated. So we want to eat in every meal something or the other. It could be a poha, upma, rice, a roti, some bread, everything is there in every meal. So we need to really reduce this as far as possible, because in India, we have something called thrifty genes. You know, so we are prone to these sort of diabetes cases because of too much of carbs. So at least the first step you do is refine carbs ban karo. If you're having too much of, let's say, white poha, then you switch to brown poha, add more vegetables in it, and it still will help. The fats is what I'm looking at, the oil, the ghee, the butter, the cheese, the red meats, the organ meats, they're all high fat. So when I'm looking at, I'm just going through this, sliding through just to give you images. So is the carbohydrates healthy? Of course it's healthy. It has got a lot of nutrition, basic energy. Definitely it is our base of our diet right from childhood. But have to watch out for how polished it is. Proteins, as I told you, it's not only the meat, it's even the dals and the whole pulses. The whole pulse, you know, that chilka, that upar covering is got the fiber, by the way. When you sprout it, it increases the vitamins. So the sprouted pulse is more beneficial than the whole pulse, more beneficial than the split dals. So again, if you're having too much of split dals, try and include a little bit of more whole dals. If you're already having whole pulses, try and go to sprouts. Then we come to fruits and vegetables. This I say, if you do not have any medical issues, just eat plenty. If there are medical issues, you have to go through a qualified dietitian to just guide you if you need to subtract some fruits and veggies, which could be hampering that particular organ. You know, like we have some famous people online saying you eat 4 mangoes, you eat 5 mangoes, and nothing will happen to your diabetes. Hello, that doesn't work. It will convert to sugar, and it is going to harm if you go ahead and eat something too much. So that should not be paid heed to. We come to fats and sweets. So don't think that only the oil you're putting in has got the fat. Even you're eating coconut, it's got fat. So even a Thai curry has fat. A til seed, almond, everything has got fats. So I don't need to only have refined oil to get the fats. I could even get the fats from eating peanuts. But if I eat too much peanut, I need to cut down the oil. Now if I look at oils, the refined oils, more harmful, let's say, than the cold pressed oils. But cold pressed are too expensive. So considering that, I could just crush some peanuts and put it in the vegetable. Which in fact, a lot of Maharashtrian recipes, basic fats like, you know, til seeds are added, coconut is added, and even groundnut is added. Even in the South Indian recipes, you have a lot of coconut added. And they're definitely low fat. So I would consider those are more healthier options. Now, if you're having ghee, just understand this is a saturated fat. So there's very little amount. If you're having coconut and ghee, you're having too much saturated fat. So there are chances that there will be a problem coming in soon. We need to be very careful on these things. Now we talk of micronutrients. Macro is done, that gives calories, but micro are equally important, though they don't give calories. They're all our vitamins and all our minerals. Luckily, last few years, people have become a little aware thanks to the supplements wala companies. Because they want to sell the supplements, that's why they are creating a lot of awareness. But if we get, let's say, food, raw food, having vitamins coming in, I don't really need to worry. But if I'm not having a salad, I'm having a cooked vegetable, and I'm reheating the vegetable one time, two times, three times, or I'm using the microwave often, I'm destroying the vitamins. So then don't count vitamins from your cooked food. Then I would say only count vitamins coming from the fruits and the salads. That's the simple way of calculation. So if there's a working person who's carrying and reheating and making the food in the morning, I don't stop them. I just say, let's not count those vitamins. Maybe just have an extra fruit. That would, you know, compensate for it. I would count the calories of that and include it in the diet. The minerals, definitely we know the most common minerals would be the iron, the calcium. But I would right now like to touch upon, considering if we have time here again, so some minerals which are not very common, but will help our immune system and also help in weight loss, because that is something very much that, you know, people are interested in doing. That's why they go in for those extreme diets. The first mineral I would look at is chromium. If there is chromium deficiency also, there is always a lot of hunger pangs, craving, all the time we are craving. So easiest way to get it down, all the greens, how broccoli was mentioned, how the greens definitely, and the non-veg I've already spoken to in the keto diet. That's the reason why it even helps in reducing hunger. This also helps in controlling the production of the insulin. We could be short of chromium, but I don't need a supplement of chromium. I would say add it from the normal food. Even if you switch to brown rice or to whole grains like a jawar, a bajra, nachni, they also do contain chromium. But if we are polishing up the grain, we are having maida, we are having white rice, we are short of chromium. Even mushrooms, for the mushroom lovers, definitely does contain chromium. Zinc. Zinc, I'm sure, again, it's become popular in terms of the zincovit and the picozinc being sold easily. Can we get it from our normal foods? I generally give to all the patients in form of seeds. So there'll be some seeds coming in of sunflower seed, pumpkin seed, it depends. And the normal food, of course. What does it do? This is the main thing for the immune system, along with definitely the vitamins. So the mineral which I would come to for the immune system, make sure the zinc is there. Now, how would you know when you have a zinc deficiency? Let's put it, you don't need to do a scan test. I will tell you a simple way. If you are not getting taste from healthy food and you're all the time craving for extra chatpata food, there are chances you have a zinc deficiency. If you're feeling very moody, you're feeling very irritable, and you're craving all the time, let me eat something spicy, let me eat something which is, you know, different from a packet, then you're craving, then you're definitely deficient in zinc. So then ensure that you probably few days take some zinc supplement and it will help. And of course, incorporate the foods. Now we come to magnesium. We always know the bones are good calcium, but the calcium will not be absorbed in our body if the vitamin D3 and the magnesium are not sufficient. And by the way, magnesium is also a mood enhancer, just to give you an idea. Yeah, so the bananas really help in enhancing the mood of a person. It increases our serotonin. Magnesium helps in bone strengthening. Magnesium deficiency and insulin resistance. There are a lot of clinical trials done. Most commonly, I would give flaxseed for this. That's how the early morning. The methi and the flaxseed is a very common thing that I would turn around and give to many people. The flaxseed also has the omega-3, which we are short of in our vegetarian diets. And the sesame seeds, good in calcium, good in magnesium. So you get a power packed in just a tablespoon of dill seeds. Vitamins, we all know. But understand that even if I am having vitamins from fruit and vegetables, we do need supplements of vitamin B12 and D3. At least 8 people on 10, whichever reports I see, they are deficient in the B12 and D3. So I would recommend if people who have not tested themselves, so at least test themselves once and get the knowledge, okay, this is where I stand. And then what is the level of supplementation required? Consult a qualified dietitian or a doctor for the same. I'm sure they'll guide you depending on your levels. But please, the entire family, if anyone is not tested, please get it tested and take supplements. Because there are definite chances you could be short of it. Now we come to the green tea. Somebody mentioned on the green tea. I would enhance from our Indian kitchen. Even if I would look at coronavirus, I would look at any infection coming in our body. This magic from the kitchen, if you're having this in your daily diet, nothing will survive. Because these are the ones that can heal our body immediately. So are we saying that the bacteria and the viruses don't exist? Of course they do. They're all within us. It's not that it's going to come somewhere. It's all there. Now, our body can fight with it with a good immune system. And if you're looking at a throat issue, since we are now into the lockdown and coronavirus, I would look at tulsi and kari patta and the ginger and the haldi and the black pepper, everything very helpful in terms of being consumed. So you can boil this up and actually make a green tea. You can have the fenugreek seed separately, ginger, garlic, you can put in your food. You don't put it in the drink. If you're a non-vegan, you can take honey. If you're a vegan, honey is not vegan. It's not considered because generally they say it's for the bees. Why do you want to have it? So just for information, honey is not included in vegan diet, but included in a vegetarian diet. But definitely, I would insist every one of these people here should start consuming these items in their daily diet. And not only till the lockdown is over, at least minimum a year it will take for the immune system to build in case you keep chronically getting a sore throat. And you need to make sure that these are going in the body. Now, I would also insist on children. Now, whatever we're eating, you know, there are so many of these different diets. We're all actually, our children are imitating us. So if we are looking at, okay, I'm going into an extreme diet, would I give that same diet to my child? So whenever I say you're doing a diet, make sure that there is something that, yes, your child can also have. It shouldn't be like, you can, if you eat a salad, the child will learn. Similarly, you eat your fruits, variety of them, child will learn. So same way, if you're doing some extreme diets, have a reason why you're doing this for even your children. So you can actually share that and reason not for others, but just for yourself. Because we're first answerable to only ourselves, nobody else really. So I would say, it's totally our choice. I have got nothing against non-veg. I've got nothing against being a vegan or a vegetarian or doing intermittent fasting. I recommend all these diets and it is only decided, personalized as per the person's requirement. And what stage the person is. If he is, let's say an example, if a person is a graduate, I won't teach a PhD diet. But if I were to go on a spiritual practices, just to share a little bit about me, I used to eat non-veg and I used to enjoy it too. Chicken and eggs were my favorite, by the way. When I started doing a lot of meditations, this, I never knew the correlation, by the way, my spiritual teachers taught me. I started intermittently getting a lot of loose motions. And I didn't know why, because I was eating healthy food, I was eating home food, and I still would end up, the day I had non-veg, next day morning, my stools would not be solid. And when I checked, they said, no, if you're meditating, you're on a spiritual journey, there are chances your body will reject. Even if my tongue was asking for it, my body made sure I don't put it in my mouth. Otherwise, it was rejecting it. So that was my learning lesson, honestly. So I leave it to the biggest judge for the choice is actually your own body. If you feel you're healthy and fine with what you're eating, just continue. If you feel, no, I don't feel fine, my medical reports don't say so, then definitely wake up and do something about it. It's always a choice. And you can move one step ahead from where you are. So let's say a person who has 8 cups of tea a day, I just get them down to 2 or 3. I don't stop their tea. But if you're having 2 cups, you're not addicted to it. So definitely I can tell you stop it for 15 days and then maybe start with 1/2 cup. But at least get the addiction out. So my intention is, let's say if you're having a carrot and you don't have it for 2 days, you'll not get a headache. But if you're not having tea and you get a headache, then means you're addicted to a chemical in the tea. It's not natural what you're consuming. So might as well first de-addict and then have it by choice. Only when you enjoy it. That makes sense more. So the message to take home is what I would say, moderation. That's the key to success. Enjoy life and keep your emotions balanced. Everything works. If you're feeling guilty and eating something, trust me, it doesn't work. So what you eat, what you put in your mouth, enjoy it and you'll be more happier a person. Your health will be fine. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure speaking to all of you.
Wonderful. So we'll open now the panel for the questions. Yes. And I'm going to ask you guys, because there are many, too many of us. If I go with everyone, it will be difficult. We were 96 at one point. Right now, we are 92 people. So what I would say is put your hands up, fatafat, and then I will ask you to unmute yourself. I'm waiting. Keep putting your hands up. Okay, Poonam, go in first. Ask for your question. Thank you. Poonam, please unmute yourself, my dear.
Hi, Hema.
Hi, Tanvi. Hema is my maiden name.
Yeah, I get impressed. Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes. Tell me.
Yeah, okay. I see you also. 1 minute. Yeah, I get very impressed with intermittent diet, but I can't manage it.
And no
problem. I want to do for some time so that I lose weight. 4-5 kg.
So how many hours are you able to comfortably fast? How many hours are you able to comfortably fast?
12 hours.
Okay. So go to 13 for a week now.
12 hours.
So go to 13 hours for 1 week now.
Okay.
Don't aim at 16 at all. Just go to 13. That won't be difficult. Okay. After 1 week, if it's not too much of an effort, shift to 14. 14 you'll be for 2 weeks. And then decide. So you go gradually there. You won't suddenly reach there. Yeah, no problem.
Okay. Thanks, dear.
Thank you. That was very well answered. Let's go to Ms. Shukla. Ms. Shukla.
Yeah, I'm Shamla.
Hi, Shamla. Ask your question.
Yeah, all right. So basically, it was a wonderful session, Dr. Jyoti. Many of my questions were answered. My question is menopause and diet. What do we do that? What do we do for that? Second, I'm 54 years old and I'm working out recently. So what happened with my menopause, my tummy and, you know, I had this flabby arms and all. So basically, I got the answer that, yeah, we can even eat black chana. Chana is, you know, going to give you the protein and all for the toning up the muscles. So like, you know, for menopause and diet, so like, what do we, you know, cut down, what do we increase and how do I go about it?
So firstly, I would say is menopause itself has been hyped again by the pharma industry. menopause, our old ancestors have been having for generations. I don't even remember when my mother menopaused and she didn't say a word about it. So these hot flushes and things happening is something because we are focusing on it. So my simple thing is, if you are, let's say, having a particular symptom, like a hot flush, then an evening primrose tablet would really work. It works wonders. If you are having, let's say, just feeling hot during the afternoons, a sabza water, that's again your tulsi seeds, or abroad you get chia seeds, basil seeds, that is. Even that works. What else were you looking at in terms of menopause? If I have a lot of, bloating happening, then the reason would be different and the symptom would again decide the remedy. So honestly, I would not give a general menopause diet. It's very difficult for me to say that. I go as per symptom. Okay.
All right. So my question was, like, after menopause, you tend to have this tummy coming out and you have your flabby arms and, your skin gets tends to loose out, right? So now recently I've started working out. So basically, if I want to tone up my muscles, so what diet is recommended? That I meant.
What I'm saying is, there are many people who do not get impacted by menopause. Okay, we have it in our mind, so we let go. Our hormones, definitely there is a difference in the metabolism slowing down. Only if we stop physical activity. If you're managing your physical activity, your metabolic rate will not slow down so much. So then you don't need to worry. If you are allowing yourself, say, okay, I have menopause now, I don't feel like doing anything, then definitely all these effects will come. Personally, what I'm saying is, it is not necessary that every menopausal lady puts on weight. And, it can even happen at 40 when you're still having your periods. So as the age progresses, if I were to look at the age graph, when we are looking at a person who's in the growing stage, he will have a high metabolism. Then we all hit a plateau. So let's say by 25 or 30, the adolescence is over, the growth phase is over. Then till, let's say, 40 or 45, we are onto a plateau. But seeing the corporate culture, there are many people who even hit a graph going upward and they don't wait for menopause to go higher on the tummy XYZ. Now, once this 45, 50, or sometimes even for people who are 60, the graph comes downward. What is downward means the muscle drops, the metabolism slows down. Then only will the problem start. Now, I'm suggesting is that you can still remain on the plateau if you are physically active. So I would have even a 65-year-old or a 70-year-old, let's say even a Milind Soman's mother would run at
least fit.
Exactly. So it is not age-related, it's activity-related.
Okay. And how much protein should be taken? How much protein should be taken by, different age groups?
So the textbook says 1 gram per kg ideal body weight is what our body requires for maintenance of the muscle. And for a low protein, it's 0.8 gram. For a high protein, a 1.2. So we calculated, it's very, again, whatever your questions are, can be only very specific to a person and nothing general. But this is the basic answer. 1 gram per kg of ideal body weight is what you need.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Wonderful. So let's go to the next person. A request to all of you. Please keep your mics mute. Otherwise, the recording will have a problem. And I have a gift for all of you. We will be recording her whole talk. And I will put it up on the link in the group. You can all go and avail it in the group. I will tell Jyoti to put it. I will also put it on the Facebook. So people who cannot go on the group or doesn't want to join the group can go straight on the Facebook and pick it up. Okay? So the link should be ready by tomorrow. The next person is Sheetal Gupta. And others, please put up your hand. Otherwise, I'm not going to call your name. So please put your hand up. Thank you. Not raising hand like that, Anaga. I want you to raise
your
hand in the Zoom call. Put over there raised hand signal.
There is a function there. Near the chat. Yeah.
Guys, for everyone, I'm sorry, when I say hands up, it doesn't mean physical hand up. On the Zoom, put your hand up on the Zoom. Very good.
Hello, Yeah. Good evening, Dr. Jyoti.
Yes, yes. Tell me.
Yeah. Good evening, Dr. Jyoti. So I am a borderline diabetic, yet not on medications, and I am able to comfortably do 14 hours of intermittent fasting. Now, my challenge is, how do I break the fast? Being borderline diabetic, I cannot have dates or too much of fruits. So, what do you recommend to break the fast and how do I go about it?
Who said that you can't have dates or fruits? Yes, Sheetal, who has informed you this?
So, let me have a date. I'm fine.
Hello, Sheetal?
Sheetal, your voice is cracking. Could you speak again, please? Thank you.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yes, Sheetal.
Now, you can hear me now?
Yes.
So, the challenge is I could have one date or fruits. What is it? What do you recommend? Should I have both? I mean, is there any capping that I cannot have fruits and dates together so that it gives a sudden rise to my sugar levels?
So, a couple of things. One is, if you're a diabetic, because you have visceral fat around your pancreas and not because insulin is produced less, or is it insulin being produced less? We'll have to do a blood test for that. Second is that I do not stop fruits for both. Okay, even if it is either case. Fruits are something that I would say we are born to have. We're all from the monkey kingdom. Monkeys survive on fruits. So fruits is something, don't give up. Okay, don't be against them. Don't be scared of them. They will only heal. They will never harm.
Correct.
Get that first. Second thing what I recommend is take a private consultation. It would help you. And I can guarantee you this diabetes will be a bye-bye for you. Because you've still not started your medication. That's the best space you can be in.
Jyoti, please put your number on the group that we have made in the WhatsApp.
Perfect.
Guys, people who don't have the WhatsApp group link, I will put it up again for you guys on the Facebook so that you can connect with it. Okay? So Jyoti can put her name. You can say the phone number loudly right now for everyone to copy.
Yes, I've just put it on the chat, but yes, I can say it.
Could you please?
982-000-8258. Yes.
Once more, slowly.
982-00-8258.
Very good. So people who need to consult her privately can do that by calling her up on this number. Also give your email, please. Thank you.
Kiran, if you have my visiting card, can you share it on the chat? Just in case, that just becomes easier.
I'll do that.
Thank you so much, Kiran. Really appreciate. Is Sheetal your question answered? Can we go to the next person? Or you have any other question, Sheetal?
Yes, please. Thank you so much.
Could you please kindly mute yourself? Thank you so much. Really appreciate. Rajesh Verma. Rajesh Verma ji, please unmute yourself and speak. You're muted, my dear. Okay, I've unmuted you. Okay, now you can speak.
Okay, hi.
Hi, sir.
Lovely hearing you. Today I got a yogurt which was lactose free. It is made of milk but lactose free. So since I'm lactose intolerant, can I have that yogurt?
Let me say, all the yogurt is lactose free. It is just a marketing technique. In the yogurt, the chemical composition of lactose is converting to lactic acid, and that's how yogurt is made.
Okay.
So you can freely have it either which ways, even if it is not marketed as lactose free. You can have simple yogurt if you are lactose intolerant. But if you are casein intolerant, that's a milk protein that is still there in this yogurt too.
Oh, no, because I made yogurt at home. Then I can continue having that, right?
Absolutely.
Okay, fine. Great. Yeah, thanks.
So Kiran is just sharing my visiting card. You can take a screenshot or something. I don't know.
Doctor, I've just WhatsApped you your visiting card.
Wonderful.
I have it, but great.
Okay, let's go to the next person. Wonderful question, wonderful answering. Lavina Katpal. Lavina, unmute yourself.
Yeah. Yes, I have unmuted myself. So, Jyoti, you are aware of my diet and the pattern of my eating also. So, I have two queries. Number one, I am generally on fruit, like on the raw diet till around 12:30, 1 o'clock. So, my query is, can I have during that period the special tea that you know I make of kari patta?
Yes, yes, yes. Because it's natural. Go ahead and have it. Yeah. As many times, okay. Anytime.
Okay, so that morning also. Number two, my query is, like, I love to eat cooked meal, but it's my experience that when I am on completely, like, totally cooked meal, 2-3 meals of cooked, then I find a lot of difference in my body posture, in my body structure, in my mood, and my lethargyness. But as I switch to, like, 50-50 raw and cooked meal, like right now I'm having one cooked meal and one raw meal, so I'm very alert, energetic, and like I can work, I'm managing a whole house completely by myself. So like, how I can pull on for the lifetime like this?
Do you enjoy what you feel?
Pardon? I enjoy both the things. I love to eat also, yeah. Like cooked meal. Yeah, I love to eat cooked meal also, but I can't. My body doesn't support that.
So what situation would be that you have two cooked meals and two uncooked meals to begin with?
Okay.
Two cooked and two uncooked. Okay, thank you. Satisfy both your plans, yeah?
Wonderful.
Yeah, okay.
So in the garden of your heart...
Okay, wonderful. Let's go to the next question. Vibhuti Khatri.
Yeah, hi. Hi, Mariji. Nice talk. So I wanted to ask you, I am a vegetarian right now since a few months. I have lived on eggs. My breakfast 365 days used to be eggs. Now I'm transitioning to veganism, but one very big problem that I'm facing is hair loss. So could the two be connected? Could it be that I am not eating eggs? Which is why the hair loss.
Yes, because there is biotin and there is high protein, which is first class protein in the eggs. And so you could just take a supplement for a while till your body gets used to. Because from childhood, I understand you've been doing this. Ideally, I would say you should have switched to alternate day eggs first, because you didn't have any medical issues, and gone slowly and weaned yourself off. Because you went suddenly, the body was getting some product and repairing the air for that. So it was used to that source. You know, we need to give an alternate source to the body. Don't confuse the body too much. That's what I would suggest. If you're very clear you're going to veganism, take a supplement for some time. It will settle. The body will get used to it. It will use the other sources. Yes, Vibhuti?
Wonderful. Vibhuti, any other question?
No other question. Thank you.
Thank you so much. That was lovely. Veer Shah, please unmute yourself. Thank you.
Hi.
Yes, yes. Tell me. I can't see you.
Just want to know, is it advisable to have a protein-rich breakfast or a protein-rich dinner?
Do you do workouts?
Yeah.
What time?
Morning and evening.
Both. Which is your intense workout? What time is your intense workout?
Morning.
Then have it after that.
Sorry?
Have the protein after the intense workout.
Okay.
Because there will be more muscle repairing happening at that time. So repairing of that would also be needed. No?
Okay. So thank you.
So even if, let's say, you don't have it in breakfast and you have your workout later, you could have the protein in your lunch. No problem. But definitely make sure that when you worked out, your next meal is followed by some protein. So whatever you have toned muscles in during the workout will also be repairing because of the raw material you're providing.
Thank you.
Just a special announcement. We have tarot card reading and angel card reading after this. If any of you are interested, you will have to raise your hand later for that. Okay, let's go to the next person. MC Rathod.
Yes.
MC Rathod, please. Please unmute yourself and then speak.
Hello.
Yes, yes, tell me.
Yeah, hi Kitty. Yeah, I wanted to ask, is there a source where you can get vegetarian collagen?
I'm not getting your voice. Can you repeat?
Is there a way where you can get vegetarian collagen? A source for vegetarian collagen? Yeah. Okay.
Why do you want it?
For skin repairing, yeah.
There is a couple of sources available, but the most common ones available are the non-veg source. So, you know, it's like I would suggest the very simple way is to start even having the peels of vegetables. So have the vegetables which you can even not peel so much. You know, like carrot, you have an option, you peel it or you don't peel it. Mm-hmm. So try and have that. That also helps in repairing skin.
Okay.
You don't have to resort to a non-veg source in case you're vegan. But most of the sources or the supplements available are with a non-veg source.
Okay.
Because it doesn't really last for long. You know, it doesn't have a long shelf life. That's the issue. So that's why I'm saying, you know, how you keep a vegetable, you can't last it for a longer time. And then there has to be a chemical form of it. So honestly, no, not as yet.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Let's go to Anaga. I think she raised her hand on screen. Anaga, you wanted to ask something? Anaga, do you want to ask something? Please unmute yourself. She's frozen there. I'm trying to unmute her. She's not going unmute. Okay, let's go to the next person and then come back to her. The next person who's raised their hand is Preeti Katpal. Preeti?
Yes, yes. I unmuted. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay, hi. I had multiple queries. One was collagen. So do you advise people to have collagen powder?
Yes, I do.
That is something I can start taking.
Very safe. Very safe.
It's safe. No problem, okay.
But it is from the non-veg source, most of the products. If you're a non-vegetarian,
so now, I have, I can't control carbs. I have to eat carbs every day. So I've switched to brown rice, but roti. What is the best option to eat roti? Jawar or what? Bajra, what can I have?
So let's say now, wheat, say comparatively, a jawar has got more fiber. So what fills you up? Basically, the more polished the grain is, the more you feel that you want to have more quantum. I'll give you an example. Let's say you have a big 30 grams of rice, 30 mm-hmm. grams of wheat, 30 grams of jawar. It's the same calories, by the way. Nothing is high cal there, okay? So even rice is not high cal.
Okay.
The only thing is because it is polished, we tend to eat a little extra. So let's mm-hmm. say one jawar roti, how much that can fill you up? You'll need two fulkas to fill you up, or maybe two soup bowls of rice to fill you up, what a jawar roti can do. So consider what is more coarser the grain, that is what is more healthy if you want to control your weight. If you just want to maintain, enjoy all the grains turn by turn. Keep switching the grains. You can have one grain at a time, one for lunch, one for dinner. Nachni is good in calcium. Bajra is a little heaty for our Indian weather in this time, but you could have it maybe for dinner, not for lunch. And you also have the barley, you have some quinoa, you have couscous, you have so many grains available today. The millets, everything is healthy. So make sure your one meal has only one grain, not too many grains. That's how you will sort the problem.
Okay. And heating food. So if we've cooked food like in the morning and heating food is killing the nutrients. So
you're reducing it every time that you eat it. Yes.
So you recommend that we should eat room temperature food?
I recommend make it fresh and eat it that time. But if that's ideally not possible, don't bother. Eat more of fruit and salad than the cooked vegetable. That's what I would look at.
Okay, and having curd at night, that's not a problem?
No problem.
Okay.
With Ayurveda, there's a problem. I don't have a degree with Ayurveda, but I know Ayurveda says That's an issue for a lot of people who have a pitta issue. But that is supposing if you're doing an Ayurvedic treatment, then you need to consult the Ved accordingly. Personally, I don't say a no for it.
Okay.
If you have an issue, then don't eat it. Very simple.
All right, that's all. Thank you.
Wonderful questions, wonderful answering. Let's go to Divya. Divya, you have question. Please unmute yourself.
Yes. Hima, if you could just throw a little more light on intermittent fasting along with dry fasting.
Okay. So let's say now the Ramzan is going on. Okay. So what are they doing the entire day? That's called dry fasting because they are not having even water. In our weather, it is very difficult because we are in humid weather and we are sweating out all the time. So personally, I feel that is a little more impractical to do for many. So if you're sitting in the AC, AC office, AC home, and you are able to not sweat out and you're not feeling thirsty, then a dry fast is still doable. But I won't really recommend and insist on dry fast. I even say keep sipping on water because when I test the scan machine pay of what I have, if I test the water percentage, out of 10 people, I would say 6 or 7 or maybe 8 people would be short of water percentage. So...
It's just a dry fast along with the intermittent period, like some do in the night, the 14-hour fast with the dry thing. Is that more beneficial? Because it's said that one dry fast is equal to 3 days of intermittent fasting.
See, I again say, what is practically possible, only do that. You know, we have stages where you can reach and stages where you can't. So first, are you doing intermittent fasting of 16 hours? Start with that.
Yeah, 14. But when I have a dry fast, it's like super. In the night, I don't have to get up for urination or anything. Yeah.
I'm not stopping you. But at the same time, is it some magic going to happen? Nothing like that.
Okay.
I wouldn't say that.
I was just asking for the insulin part. They say, you know, it helps in the insulin resistance. The sensitivity.
It will just help in healing. But even if I'm, let's say, having a natural green tea, it will not harm the healing. It's just going to make my kidney work, right? There's not too much of liver work. What is the main problem people are facing today is a fatty liver in the urban life. So when we're looking at urban life, first let's heal the liver, then we worry. If the kidney is an issue, then you do the dry fast. Okay. Anyways, the doctors reduce the water intake if the urine has stopped. So again, we're getting very clinical here. So if you have a specific thing, you know, it's very difficult to generalize this stuff.
Okay.
So if I look at a specific person, it's very wrong if I state a statement saying dry fast is good, I could be harming more than benefiting many people. Okay. So I wouldn't say that really. It just sounds good, but it doesn't do good very often. It can harm.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, let's go to the next person. Divya, could you please mute yourself? Okay, wonderful. Let's go to the next person, Rinku Singh.
Yes, hi.
Hi.
Hi,
Rinku. Yes.
And thank you, Dr. Jyoti. Nice to hear. I have one query. Yes. I always prefer to do intermittent diet. I on my menopause and my like weight is stubborn, like it doesn't move how much diet I do. So now whenever I do the intermittent diet, I get my gastric problem. And I got the reflux. And because of that, my cough was not stopping. At last, I came to know, I visited doctor, then my homeopathic doctor said that is because of your this diet issue. So what's your advice me in that?
Because if a person has digestive issues and is acidic in nature, I do not recommend intermittent fasting in the beginning for sure. It's not the initial diet. First correct the acidity. First correct the gastro system. Because what are you healing if you're not first providing the nutrition? Are you getting me? Now, let's say our house is dirty. Giving an example. House mein kachra hai. And I say, now I'm shutting the door and it will clean. It won't clean if I don't provide the cleaning material. How will it clean? So first, I need to organize the cleaning material. So only if it is a clean one, then I can probably decorate it with something. Just giving you a house example.
Yeah.
If already cleaning is done, then you get some lovely wall paintings and lovely whatever stuff and make the house look good. But if you're already in a dirty house and then you're saying, I got the painting done. Okay. You know, that's how it sounds like. You start an intermittent fasting on an acidic body, it's going to harm more than good. So first correct the acidity with alkaline food. But give it food to eat because it won't heal. The gastro system cannot heal if it doesn't have nutrition going in. So there's a nutritional issue first. So intermittent fasting is not for you. As of this phase, you could probably do it later, but not at this phase. No ways.
Okay. One more thing is there, doctor. Whenever I take the barley or jowar, that atta, you know, whenever I want to, I feel more bloating. I feel more my, you know, heaviness I feel.
Correct. I'm able to get what your gastro system is completely. You will first have to clean that gastro system. You will have to go on more of a rice diet initially, then go. You know how a child has got a loose motion or a constipation. What will we give the child? We'll give light food. We'll give khichdi. We'll give rice and dal. Are you getting me? So you will not be able to eat a jawar roti if you have a bad stomach, no? Even if jawar is healthy.
Yeah. So you advise me.
Beyond this, I'll have to give you a personalized diet and you will recover out of this in 15 days. But definitely we have to monitor the diet strictly. As per this time, this has to go in. It won't happen as a general talk. Let me be very specific on that.
Yeah, I will be in touch.
I recommend you don't do anything on your own because you're going to harm if the acidity increases. It will harm the organs, right?
Yeah.
Yes, Anu.
Thank you.
I would say, Rinku, go consult Jyoti. She's amazing. And get the diet organized with her. Okay?
Definitely. Definitely. Thank you. Thank you so much, Doctor.
Most welcome. Next person is Izhar Khan. Izhar Khan.
Yes.
Oh, you're able to hear me?
Yes. There's a lot of disturbance, but tell me.
Mr. Khan, awaaz theek nahi hai.
It's better?
Yeah, okay.
So I've been knowing Jyoti for some time and she has really, you know, showed us the right way of life. I've lost almost 15 kg in 6 months' time. Okay.
Wow.
Jyoti, wanted to ask you is right now in this lockdown situation, because we are, as you know, we are in-house and we are having, although a controlled diet, but still it's just an inflow, no exercise, nothing. And as you rightly said, there is some throat issue which has been recurring, you know, once in a week or something like that. So as you said, there are certain, you know, a tea that you recommended. So I would like to know about that. And can we take some precaution due to this lockdown and this COVID situation? Because they are saying it is more prone to if you have certain things and diabetes is one of them. So would you recommend any precautionary things that we can take care?
First, Isra, your sugars are all in control. So remove this fear out. That's my request to you. Okay? Don't worry at all for this virus. The fear is going to cause more of a mess than anything else. I will give you that herbal drink. I could even send it across. I could share it on my Facebook page. But definitely, I could share it across in this group as well. So the herbal drink, which is helping for the sore throat or for the immune system, can be consumed every day by everyone. No worries at all. And you will be safe. I can assure you, Isra. Don't worry at all. Because I know your case. So forget about the diabetes. Your body is already healed out of it. It doesn't exist anymore. Just don't worry.
Wonderful. So that will be a real gift from you to everybody. Sure. That's the herbal tree that you're going to be giving. A special request to all of you. Could you please go on the Facebook and at least put your how did you find the session? So that, you know, it's nice that Jyoti can see the feedback. She's done such an amazing job. And guys, if you can put it on the group too. Thank you. Anybody else right now? I don't see any more hands up. So we will calling out once. Any more hands up? Any more questions? Yes, me. Who is this? Krish. Please unmute yourself. Thank you. Please unmute yourself and ask your question.
I can't hear anyone.
Karish. Mr. Karish, please unmute yourself. Can I talk here? Of course you can talk here. You don't want to unmute yourself. You just want to put it in the chat.
Yeah, okay, fine. It won't unmute, not working. That's not possible, Karish. I will unmute you. Just give me a minute.
We have a lot of people from abroad. Even she's from abroad. Even Verma was from Dubai. A lot of people from abroad have joined.
Karish, is your phone number with just K?
Oh, no.
Yeah, okay. I think I've unmuted you. Have you got unmuted? Hello?
K is, Karish is another person.
Okay. Karish is another person. Okay. Yes. Karish, I'm unmuting you right now. That's interesting.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi. 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 How are you, Jyoti? I just want to see you. I'm with Jyoti since 2018. She's very good. Anyone who has a doubt about consultation, please go ahead. She explains everything very well, and it's really straightforward, whatever she offers. I've heard a lot about recently Bullet Coffee and Bulletproof, whatever it's called on the internet. How does one, if they want to try, or they say when you do, or on a keto diet, should you be doing it with intermittent fasting? It helps a lot more. What is your take on that? I'd like to know.
So primarily for the people who are not aware of Bulletproof Coffee, it's basically black coffee with a lot of coconut oil or butter or ghee, whatever is available as a high fat. So it doesn't have carbs at all. And it triggers the fat. So it's something like on the ketogenic diet, it works very well. But there are many people who also have it otherwise. How does it help? It really triggers immediately the system, you know, which I explained to you as a diagram, that the energy, once you've got up from fasting, will either come in, let's say, from a fruit you have, or it will come in from your fat reserves. No? So that's the time that you were giving the fat to actually burn out. So it's always before a workout. It's never had and you going to work and, you know, just sitting at home. No, it's before an intense workout that the bullet coffee would help if you do not want to, let's say, have a date or a fruit. That's when it is used. Because you need energy when you're working out. That's why.
Yeah. What's the best time to have it? That was my only question. A lot of people are having an empty stomach morning, but before the workout. Perfect.
So if you're not acidic, only then, because coffee is very acidic in nature.
Yeah. Yeah.
Again, there is no thing everyone can have this. No. So it is for a normal person who is on a ketogenic diet or a low-carb diet, has stopped sugars totally, can have this pre-workout. So the intensity of the workout increases. You know, it's something like how they have a pre-workout drink as a commercial product. This works equivalent in terms of giving energy, but you save the money that you're spending on that pre-workout drink.
Correct.
A homemade solution for it. Otherwise, I wouldn't say that. If nobody is working out, please don't start having black coffee there. It won't help.
Okay. Perfect. Thank you so much.
Wonderful. Any more questions? You still have the last chance. Okay, Poonam, go ahead.
Hi. It's a really wonderful lecture and very good knowledge. Now, my last question, tell me the food which are rich in zinc. Common food.
Okay. I've shared it on the slide, but I'll tell you. Basically, all the greens will have, the whole wheat, even the grains have it. So anything which is unpolished will have zinc. Anything which is more polished will not have the zinc goes out first. The first thing, if you're short of zinc, means you will crave for kachara only. If you're that sort of a chatpat person, then I would suggest 15 days take a zinc supplement. Then add a healthy food also at the same time.
What zinc supplement should they take?
So, Bico Zinc or a Zincovit are the most common ones. And there are many supplements.
Can you write that down?
Even an A to Z will have the Z is the zinc. All of them work. Yeah, I'll write it down.
Thank you. Maybe you can put it on the group and I can put it on the Facebook then. Last chance, guys. Anybody for a last question?
Anu, I want to ask a question.
Please go ahead. Please go ahead, Dr. Manorama.
Hi Jyoti, lovely session.
Thank you.
What is your take on protein supplementation? that is whey protein. How do you recommend it?
For a sports person, yes, I do recommend whey protein.
Otherwise, for
helpful. Otherwise, for a normal person, so what we do is we first start with, can you get your protein source from food? If I can give it to you from the food, at least you're getting satisfaction of eating something. But if you're doing a heavy workout, then whey protein is convenient. Overdoing whey protein supplements or any other protein supplements can do more harm than good. I've attended a lot of cases in hospitals where these bodybuilders are at 45-50 with a lot of kidney failure issues. So I do give the disclaimers. I don't suggest any of these protein supplements in excess. You have to make sure that the muscle is really being toned, and then you will need that much to repair. So it's calculated and given. And the Herbalife is another thing that I do not recommend. There are enough clinical trials on it. Since we're on to protein supplements, I would also say that's another big marketing thing. Clinical trials do suggest a liver issue coming up. You know, if somebody really wants a clinical trial being shared, I can do that. It's there on my Facebook page. But people need to be aware, because these are all being marketed on our faces. So there is, if somebody is promoting something, first see, I always check if a clinical trial is also being done by some company who's going to promote some product. I don't go by it. I go by a neutral person or a doctor who's done it without going to get any benefit out of it. That is for sure authentic. I'm just giving you an insight, because today diet has also become a business. Sad to say, but that's where it is. So we need to be very careful on, you know, I'll give you another sentence on fats. I'm surprised that there was no question on the fats this time in every session of mine. But, you know, many oils do write cholesterol free on their, you know, when they're selling, they're marketed that way. Now, if we are just for information, no plant makes cholesterol only. So all the oils are cholesterol free. But I've heard a lot of people saying, you know, maybe groundnut oil has cholesterol. That's why they don't write it. Or maybe rice bran oil has cholesterol. So no, there is nothing like that happening. But they're good at marketing, so they write down cholesterol free. That's about the difference. And all the oils are same calories, by the way. 1 ml, 9 calories. So do you think this oil is safe and not safe? It doesn't work.
Yeah. And what is your take on the very famous Dixit diet these days?
Dixit is very close to intermittent fasting.
Right.
Two meals.
The people who are vegan prefer to go for that diet and only two times a meal, and they say acidity problems. So do you really recommend that?
Primarily, what he is claiming
without consultation.
No. So primarily what I say is I can get the same result with 4 or 5 meal pattern. I don't need to go on a 2 meal pattern. And there are at least around 7 to 8 people in this same audience who can vouch for these words. Okay. Who have not having diabetes anymore, and they have eaten well. So they have not been starved to having 2 meal pattern. So it's a choice if you want to take it as a lifestyle. But if you want to eat a proper meal, just guide it and have it. According to me, to fit all the calories in 2 meals is way more tougher. If I can space it out, it is more satisfying for the patient and for me. Are you kidding me? But if it's a choice that you want to make, I'm not against Dr. Dixit, but I would say nutrition is something that he's not specialized in. He's an MBBS doctor, and he's got good political contacts, and he's become popular. But all the time, I also know a lot of people who have followed his diet and have backfired very badly.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So, you know, it doesn't really work for everyone.
Yes.
That's not something I would recommend. So I always say again, it's a choice. That's the reason why I named that as the title, you know. But I wouldn't promote it for sure. Yeah.
And do you recommend fruits after evening?
After evening means after sunset?
Yes.
Yeah, if you're or not following a Jain diet, go ahead and have your dinner.
Later part of the day.
I don't have a problem. If people come from office at 9 at night or 10 in the night, they're going to eat their dinner at that time with the family.
No, no,
I
not
don't
dinner.
Stop it.
Not dinner fruits. I'm talking about fruits.
Oh, fruit. Okay, fruit. The fruit rule that I follow is 1 hour before a cooked food or 3 hours after a cooked food, not with the cooked food.
Okay.
Got the connect? So, and this is a naturopathy rule.
that I follow. Yeah, because fruits, if you are not active in the later part of the day, fruits give you glycemic overload. So do you recommend that?
So if let's say now evening you had a heavy meal at 6 o'clock and you don't wish to have dinner and you just sit with one fruit, I'm okay with it if you want to have a fruit at 9. Are you getting me now? But if you're substituting, let's say, an entire meal with a big meal at fruits only, you won't get your protein in the night, then your repairing of muscle won't take place. So I prefer the protein meals for sure at night instead of fruit meals.
Okay.
But it's not that once in a while, if you already had your protein meal at 6 o'clock and you don't want to have, you can still maybe grab a fruit occasionally. But not as a lifestyle, if that's what you want to do.
Right, because in India, it is a habit that people tend to eat fruits at night as a sweet dish or maybe dessert.
That's the first thing that we stop.
Okay.
Nothing with cooked food or even 3 hours after. So then definitely no.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. If the call drops while we are doing tarot card reading, I will put the link again and you all can come back again. Now, where will you find the link? I will put it on the Facebook and I will also put it on the Facebook under wherever Jyoti's name is, including the ad that she had put, or and I will also put it on the on my group just in case if it drops. So right now,
or I can put it on my WhatsApp status for the people who have my number WhatsApp status. I can put it immediately.
Yes, that would be brilliant. Thank you so much. So what I will do right now is, Jyoti, we will ask Binayfa to come in. I am assuming that all the questions are done, and I'm also assuming that we will be able to do the tarot card and angel card reading for all of you without any breakage. So let's hope that happens. I think we have practically by 11:40 the call will break down. So we have about 12 minutes. Binayfar, are you there? Binayfar, are you there?
Yes, ready.
I can see you.
Yeah, wonderful, wonderful. Let's do first reading for Jyoti. She's done such an amazing job today.
Yes, Jyoti, thank you so much. Amazing lecture. And a lot of misconceptions were cleared, especially the fruit part. We always have fruit after dinner.
I want each and every one of you to put your feedbacks. We are not taking time for feedbacks right now, which I generally do. We are too many of us to do that. But special humble request, please do that. Please put the feedback because it's very important for the speaker to know. First tarot card reading and angel reading for Jyoti.
Yes.
Thank you, Binayfa.
Most welcome, Anu. I've picked up two cards for you. The first one is Angel Opal. And the message that you have got is your children on earth and in heaven are happy and well cared for by God and the angels. So even maybe somebody in your past life or somebody who you thought as a child, if you feel that you have even lost connect with, not necessary that it has to be a death, but even someone who was very close to you that you've lost touch with, they are safe and they are protected. And the other one is Archangel Uriel. Is this one? Who is saying that trust your inner knowledge and act upon it without delay. You know what is to be done. So go ahead and do what needs to be done.
Wonderful. Thank you so much for that, Binayfa. There is somebody called Jayashree who is requesting for a reading. If any one of you is interested, please put a message on the chat for me so that I can see it. Jayashree, could you please show her your face? Jayashree Balakrishnan, thank you so much. Binayfa, can you see her?
No.
Hi.
Can you say hi Hello. Again?
Hi. Jayashree.
Hi. Yes. Do you have any questions?
I just want a reading tarot card.
Okay. You don't have any particular question?
No. Just a general.
If you've missed anything of the session, it's going to go on the YouTube and the YouTube will be available by tomorrow. So, yeah, you can even give that YouTube to as many people. So,
Jayashree, Jayashree, I picked up two cards for you.
Yeah.
One is whatever your talents are, you will be appreciated for that. Maybe it has not happened till now. So you're going to do that. People are going to appreciate you for what you are. And you have the capabilities to spread knowledge. You have the capabilities to help a lot of people and show them the path, show them what they are meant to do in life. So please go ahead with that. And that will again help you to be appreciated. And that is what maybe somewhere you're looking for within yourself, to be appreciated.
Wonderful. We have Vibhuti, who wants you to do her reading. Vibhuti, could you please unmute yourself and say a hi and talk
to you?
Thank you. Keep talking so that Binayfa can see you.
Hi. I just wanted a general reading. There's no question.
Nothing in particular. Vibhuti, are you working or are you trying to look for a job?
I'm working right now.
Okay, so it's showing maybe a little politics happening at work and not very happy at the workplace. So you will come across somebody who's going to be of a very great emotional support to you very soon. And that person would definitely change your approach towards life and take you in the right direction.
Okay.
That will happen soon. But just beware of people at work because it's not a great scene right now. So I don't know if that is true or not in your case right now. But that is what is showing up.
All right.
Wonderful.
Okay, thank you.
Let's go to the next person. Karish is asking for her reading. Karish, could you please unmute yourself and talk? Hi. Thank you.
Hi. No question in particular, but obviously there's a lot of uncertainty after this pandemic when it gets over. So anything based on that or just a general reading, nothing in particular.
Okay.
If anybody else wants, other than Seema, Seema's name is there. Anybody else wants their cards to be read, please put the name up first so that I can see it. Thank
okay,
you.
Okay, so for you, the cards I get are that you are pretty emotional about a lot of things right now. And a lot of thoughts are going on in your mind. A lot of indecisiveness is also there. So just try and be more focused. Try and train your mind to go in one direction of what you want. You have a very scattered thought right now and you want to do maybe 10 different things. So just try and focus on what that one thing is where you feel that, okay, if I do this, maybe I know I'll get somewhere. So that is going to really help you. Focus is what you need right now. And there is somebody who's going to come into your life. Maybe you already know that person. Maybe it could be a parent or a sibling or just a friend. But somebody known, unknown, who is going to enter your life, who's going to make some sense of it, who's going to guide you in the right direction and to do the right thing in your career and at least settle you mentally. Thanks.
Wonderful. Let's go to the next person, Seema. Binayfa, you are in demand, yaar.
Thank you.
Seema, unmute yourself. Show your face.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. Chalo, no Bolo. Question in particular.
Just in general. Okay, I'm going to pick an angel card.
We have last 5 minutes left. If it cuts off, it cuts off and then we don't come back, okay? So, would like to say goodbye to all of you and we meet again tomorrow at 9:30 and let's see how long this continues. I don't know. But we meet again tomorrow 9:30 with Cora Klepp from Germany. She will be talking to you guys tomorrow and she has a lot to share around
coronavirus and otherwise. She is one of the main people in MetaHealth International, and I'm very grateful that she's going to be there with us tomorrow. And for the next few days, right up till 15th of May, we have speakers lined up from various parts of the world. Yes, Binaifa, Seema ka cards.
Yes. Seema, I picked up two angel cards for you. The first is Archangel Metatron. So the angel is telling you to prioritize, focus on your highest priorities, and I will help you get organized and motivated. That is the first one. Second one is Angel Teresa. So this card has come reversed for you, so you're not doing this. So take time out for yourself. You have been busy taking care of everyone else's needs and desires, but now it is time to stop and take care of yourself. So just
bang on.
Wonderful, guys. Please mute yourself. Thank you. Let's go to the next person fast. Rajesh Verma. Rajesh Verma.
Please say a quick hi, Rajesh Verma.
Yeah, it's Sunita here.
Hi, Sunita.
Yeah. Hi. This is just a general reading I want. Nothing in particular, just general.
Wonderful.
So you, I just got a jumping card. Are you bullied by any chance, or somebody feels that you are bullying them?
Are you feeling bullied
by somebody?
No, not really.
Okay, so maybe somebody is feeling bullied by you. So maybe you're a very strong person, mentally very strong, so people maybe tend to get intimidated by you. So just try and relax yourself. What you can do is, for you, I'm just getting this intuitively, is that you need to focus on your breath. So the more you focus on your breathing, the more you tend to relax and become less hyper if you get hyper. And the other card is a beautiful card that you have got, is of the Wheel of Fortune. So things will improve and get better than what they are now. So right now is the time for improving yourself, not only emotionally, but more, I'm getting a mental focus for you. You just need to be more focused mentally and take it easy. Don't overstress yourself or don't overthink.
Oh, great. Thank you. Thank you.
Wonderful.
Very much.
Wonderful. Let's go to the next person. Lavina Katpal.
Thank you. So my question is, I'm worried about my son who's in Chicago at this time and all alone in the room in his apartment. So I'm worried about him.
Okay, so there's nothing to worry about. He's going to be good. There's no worries. I'm getting very good cards.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. Let's go to the next person, Preeti. Preeti Katpal.
Yeah, I'm here. Wonderful. I wanted to know about my work, because I'm in the entertainment field, and people are saying for the next 6 months there will be no events happening. So, what can I do? Like, should I start another career? What can I do?
How will the situation be?
Just wait, things will improve. And for you right now, even if you do, it's going to take time. But if you stick on to what you're doing, it's showing a luxurious life for you, actually.
Okay, so also, just hang on. Also about marriage, like my mother wants me to get married, but I don't think I'm ready.
We are just doing one question right now for everyone, so everyone gets the chance.
Lavina, sorry, Preeti, ask your mom to get married. Don't get married.
Lavina is her mom.
So just tell Lavina to get married and you don't get married. That's for you, Lavina. The next person that you read cards for is Rinku Singh.
Yes, hi.
Hi.
I just want to ask about my son. He's in Toronto right now, alone in his apartment. same story. He is busy in his job, but he's waiting for any promotion right now. His interviews are going on.
So you want to know about the promotion or?
Yeah, for my son and how his job will be there.
Zoom has been very kind. It's going on, stretching. It's 11:41. It's still going strong.
He'll get the promotion in around 6 to 8 months.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you so much. Sir. Let's go to the next person, Sushil Manchanda. Sushil Manchanda.
Hi, I'm Reshma. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Binay.
Hi. Any question in mind or nothing? Okay. Okay, so what I'm getting for you is just try to be mentally a little de-stressed. There's too much stress happening around you, and there is too much of self-imposed, like you're in a self-imposed cage. Okay, wow. So nobody's put you there. You can just walk out any minute, any second, actually, but you're just there. The thoughts that are going through in your mind are just like you're waiting for a disaster to happen. So please come out of that stage. I mean, it's, nothing is so bad. All you need to do is just shift your focus from the good to the bad, from the bad to the good. Sorry.
मैं उड़ना भी चाहूँ तो दूर आसमान वो हाल है आपका. Next वाला. Next. Thank you so much, Hemal. When इनकी शादी कब होगी ये जानना चाहती हैं Hemal.
Hemal. Okay.
Hemal अपनी शकल दिखा दे. झलक दिखला जा. इनकी शादी कब होगी ये जानना चाहती है. When will I get married? Will it be arranged or love? एक ही question madam. आप वाकई demand में हो आज बिनाइफर.
You could get married by end of this year or just the first couple of months of the next year. So that is the time frame that I'm getting.
Wonderful.
So very very house answers. Yeah.
Wonderful. Let's go to the next person, Kiran. Kiran.
Hi.
Yes.
Hi. All right. So I think just do a general reading because I have two questions in my mind and you won't answer two and I can't choose one.
Okay, jaldi jaldi.
It's about my career and my marriage. Two questions is what I have in my mind.
Ek hi sawal dhoondo fatafat.
I am again getting that whatever you are looking for, like you're looking for some sort of justice, maybe in life or maybe at work. So you are going to get that. The truth will come out and you will get what you deserve. And stop, maybe you're not speaking up for yourself. Maybe you're not saying the things that you need to and taking a backseat. Mentally, you need to be a little more stronger and a little more vociferous. To be heard and people to notice you.
Wonderful. Last person that we are reading for is Anisha. Anisha, she just wants a general reading.
Okay.
Hey, we did it. Good. Job. Yeah, 44. Yeah. Maybe you have last 1 minute.
Anisha, okay. So Anisha, you are going to be appreciated for what you want to be appreciated for. Money is going to come in and emotionally, maybe you are not very stable right now. So somebody will enter your life who is going to bring that stability to you, who is going to bring that balance of emotion and finances in your life.
Okay. Thank you so much.
I can't believe this. Everything is done and now I can actually show you my face. Thank you so much.
Most welcome.
Bahut shukriya to both my speakers and to everybody on the forum, please go and put again an urge, please go and put your feedbacks, because feedbacks are always good. And
Anu,
also,
I have to step a card for you.
Bolo.
So the card is mystique. The card says, keep charging ahead and don't take no for an answer. Expect miraculous solutions to appear.
Thank you. That brings
so
emotion.
That is what the angels wanted.
Yeah, I came very close to shutting everything down yesterday. It was a very tough day for me. You could see the swelling on my face. And I could see it too. And then I said, that's okay. Another day and everything will be fine. And that's how it is. You are allowed to get tired and rest. But you're never allowed to give up. Because God gave you this life. Only He has the right to take it away from you. And you have no right over that before that. And for all the people who are feeling caged right there, I felt caged for many, many years. And then I said, I will fly with my cage. In the conference, I said, my cage has become small and the bird is probably flying inside still. And today I feel I am, even when I'm on a lockup, I'm flying high, guys. I have no cage. And from here on, I will never have a cage around me. I will always have freedom, a freedom of my mind, a freedom of being wherever I am. A freedom is when you have a choice. I give myself choice every day to live. Because kya fayda agar mar mar ke aap jiye? Are ek baar ji ke to mar lo. Phir dekhte hain na kaisi zindagi ji. Bye guys. Love you all. Catch you tomorrow at 9:30 again. Thank you.
We're lucky this call got extended. It's all in your clearing, Anu.
11:47. I had only scheduled it for 2 hours. So you can just see how angels are working.
Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.